have unprecedented power. With the click of a button, you can reach literally millions of people. And yet, not one person in a million knows your name. They don't know your face. And if they don't know your name and face, they don't care about your struggle. There's nothing that speaks more loudly and more profoundly than that individual face and that individual name. And that's not conjecture, that's proven. There's a fascinating study done by a University of Oregon psychology professor where he had three test groups, and he laid in front of these test groups three different sets of information. The first group got facts about the millions of people starving in Africa. The second group got the picture of a single 7-year-old child who was starving in Africa. And the third group got both a boy and a girl who were both 7 years old. And each group was allotted a particular sum of money. And he asked them, how much of this money are you willing to give? And the first group that got facts about the millions of people starving gave on average half as much as those confronted with a single face and a single name. And so I set about to tell the stories of these people, these brave individuals who went to prison for exceedingly long periods of time for no crime whatsoever. People whom were long forgotten, even by the great American Republic. And when I thought about cases like Egypt and young Karim Amer, who was 22 years old when he first went to prison, I realized that Egypt is a country that has gotten over $50 billion worth of U.S. aid. And I wondered, how is it possible? How is it possible that his name is not raised in every bilateral meeting with Egyptian diplomats? How can we let them get away with this? When I looked at Saudi Arabia,